That does look scary. Does not look fun for me. No, thank you very much.
Hello, hello. In today's video, we are talking about looking at doing things and stuff. Let's try that again. Hello, hello. In today's video, we are using the Dehancer plugin to make digital photos and videos look like they were filmed on film, or photographed on film, if it's the photo bit. We're looking at a plugin. This video has been made possible by the lovely people at Dehancer. They have sent me a key so that I can use their software and show you their software. They haven't given me anything specific to say. They want my opinions to be my opinions, which is good because that's what they were going to be anyway. Those of you that watch my videos regularly will know that I'm not very good at the technical aspects of photography, so this will be based entirely on how easy it is to use and how cool it looks. Spoiler alert! It's really easy to use, and it looks quite cool. I know bits about film photography, and one of my favourite 35mm films is Kodak Colorplus 200, so that's the profile I chose when I was editing these photos. And I know nothing about doing video on film, so I just kind of chose Kodak Vision 3, because it was at the top of the list, and it looked pretty cool. So yes, hello, hooray, good. Anywho, we'll talk more in detail about the plugin in a bit, but first, let's go to the seaside and test it out.
And we are, of course, going to start today's video at Southend Pier, Promenade and Railway, the longest pleasure pier in the world. I don't know if that's true or not, but it says it on a sign, so it must be at least partway credible. Well, if you've ever wondered what the longest pier in the world looks like, it looks like this. The end looks really far away, which is kind of expected now that I think about it out loud. The floor, the fence posts, and the sun do make for some cool framed silhouettes of people though, so, you know, that's fun. It is very peaceful walking along here. It's actually really nice just sort of looking out to sea, watching the water, the really bright sunlight burning my eyes. We have made it to the end of the pier. Look how cute this little railway station is. And there's a collection of beach huts that I suppose aren't really beach huts, they are pier huts. Looking back at the pier from the end of it now is super cool. I don't know why, but it just looks really impressive from this angle to me. It is very windy out here, which is having the normal fun effect on my hair, so hooray. At the end of the pier, you have a collection of seagulls, some benches and some lamps, a nice little area to go and sit in and relax and just have a good time. And you've got the cutest little fish and chip shop ever to fish and chip shop.
I think the photos turned out pretty cool, with a proper, like, I'm on holiday kind of vibe to them. Now let's look in a bit more detail about what this plugin does and how I've used it. As previously mentioned, I am bad at editing slash lazy, so anything that makes my life a little bit easier is always a win for me. In my normal editing workflow, I use a lot of presets to make my life easier, so functionally I'm using this in the same way. Apologies to the people at Dehancer if you wanted me to use it a bit more in depth. Let's go onto the desktop and have a look at what we're working with. This is our base photo. So if we right click here and select Edit in Dehancer, it will open the Dehancer window. Down the left here, you've got a selection of different films. Like I said earlier, we're going to use Kodak Colorplus 200. Then on the right are lots of options and lots of configuration you can do to get the photo just right. I'm not going to go through everything, but if you would like to see me do that, leave a comment down below. The three things we're going to be looking at are bloom, halation, and grain. These are the main things in here, and these are what make the biggest impact on your photo. Let's start with bloom. Ticking this option adds some bloomy, glowy softness to your images. And if you want to see where this effect is being applied, you can press the mask button to see just where it's being applied in the image, and you can make any of your adjustments accordingly here. Next up, we've got halation. This is a word that I did not know until I got this software. Halation is that kind of red glow type effect you see in really contrasty areas of film photos and videos. Just like with the bloom, there is a masking tool available so that you can see which parts have been halationed. Halated? Halatified? I don't know what the past tense of halation is. Does halation have a past tense? And finally, we've got grain. Grain is the one I understand, because this is what adds grain to your photos. This is the thing that makes it look like somebody poured sand onto your photos. It looks really cool though. For me, this and the halation are the two things that make the photos look older than they are. And that's it. Our photo is finished. You can tick and untick this box to preview your changes if you want to. I like waiting until the end to do this because you get sort of a really dramatic before and after and it looks really cool. And that's that. If you like the look of this and you want to give it a try, there is a link down below. Click on it, go and look at the website. There is a free trial available, so you lose nothing by going and checking it out. It is super duper simple to use. It must be because I can use it and I'm really dumb. Guys, I'm so stupid. And if you decide you really, really love it and you want to buy it, please use code CAMERALIZARD when you are doing so and you'll get 10% off. And it helps me, which is good because I enjoy being helped and I'm sure you enjoy spending less money than full price. But that is all for now, so thank you very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed. I hope this has been informative and educational and all of the other things it was intended to be. Goodbye. 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 Thank you again very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed. I actually really liked using this plugin, although it was very intensive on my poor computer. This video took like 9 hours to export, so maybe it's time for an upgrade there. But it's fun. I enjoyed myself. I hope you enjoyed yourself. See you. Goodbye.